My name is Mitchell Kay. I'm a PhD student at the Department of Biology at the University of Waterloo. My research is really unique because we get to time travel. So we get to go through time, and how we do that in this very complicated way is we take sediment cores from lakes located in northern Alberta, right on the border of the NWT where Wood Buffalo National Park is. And inside that, we have two major rivers that meet and create this flood-prone system. So next cool part about my research, we fly around in a helicopter all these lakes, and we take sediment cores from these lakes. From that, we're able to reconstruct what the conditions were like 100, 200, 300, sometimes up to thousands of years ago, and allow us to create baseline conditions or what the range of natural variation is for this system. And why that's important is there's been two major industry projects that have been placed on each of the major rivers. So to the south and north of Fort McMurray, or south of the pad, is the oil sands operation. So this massive operation where they're mining bitumen, and then we have a dam that's located on the Peace River, which is the other major river. And there's lots of concerns about water quality and water quantity coming down these rivers. And since we didn't know what the conditions were like before these major projects, or had very, very small monitoring records, we don't know if they've changed the range of natural variability, or they've altered the system in a way that's going to be detrimental to human health downstream. One of the coolest things happening in our field right now is they're actually trying to extract DNA from the bottom of the sediment cores and look at, you know, what the abundance of some of these things were. 10, 20 years ago, that wasn't even possible. So ever expanding, and you know, the next wave of grad students that are coming in are the people who are going to be riding these new exciting waves and questions. So you can be a part of some of the most exciting part of research that's happening right now, because every field is developing at such a rapid pace.